He said, "I'm more so nervous for this." He loves that one, bro.
Game time.
Love it. Love it.
I'm telling you, bro. Like you can't prepare.
Honey, why don't you tell everyone what you thought? Well, she doesn't want to talk to the camera, which is funny because she always talks to the camera. Yeah, see, she's laughing because she knows I'm right. She thought that I was going to propose at a dinner. A dinner.
I know I'm right. A dinner that you didn't tell me about? Oh boy.
A dinner that I forgot to mention while she was gone when the whole mentioning of the dinner came up.
Lies.
Lies. It's not a lie. Last night, Lola thinks that she's puzzled it together. Says that because a friend of her texted about dinner after skydiving, and I had forgotten to tell Lola about dinner, there must be something about to happen at dinner. She was awfully close. Really close. But wrong. It was interesting. She was so convinced she was right. And I had to swear that I had no plan to propose at dinner, which is true. Which is true. I did not plan to propose at any dinner. That was never the plan. I did admit to considering proposing while dropping in the air to her, which initially she thought was really stupid, and that kind of made me go, ooh. But that also was not the plan. It's when we're on the ground, after we're done falling, before dinner.
An update to the secret proposal plan. Booked at dinner. It'll be about 20 people, 23 people. Vetted all of them to make sure that they're doing what they can on COVID, and some of them with negative tests and all that. It's a patio, an outdoor dinner. Got to keep it 2020 friendly and everything. And, you know, really don't want to risk anybody for this. Which has been, it's been a difficult plan to pull off because of that. I thought about catering and bringing people here, but then it's like, then I'd have to clean the whole house. And Lola's not seen me clean the whole house out of nowhere, maybe like a room here or there. So, you know, gotta keep it believable and normal. I'm ashamed to admit that. She really does a lot that I am appreciative for. But yeah, so... finally decided to book that dinner. It's an outdoor patio, our own private space, so we don't have to mingle with the peons in the regular part of the restaurant. So that'll be at Parkside Garrett, which has been a whirlwind to try to find places that can do this during COVID that I feel safe about, that I feel okay about, you know, making sure it's outdoor but still nice. Stole some contacts from her phone a couple days ago, and from her computer just now, to make sure that those who, you know, she would have said, sorry, Patricia and Nada, hopefully you're not upset that I didn't actually invite you to come all the way out here to Austin, but made sure to get your numbers though so you can watch the live Zoom feed. Did get a friend of hers, Oakley from Houston, her number, and she's gonna be there for the proposal. So some sleuthing, which I really don't like doing. But accomplished that. Really, one of the cool things is they allow us to have a personalized menu. So I left a message for Lola there. I can't remember exactly what it said, but it was, she is the most joyful and loving woman I've ever met. And that's true. Her ability to love through ups and downs is, it's awesome. She's a very strong, strong woman. And it's time to propose. I'm walking into the jeweler. Lola believes I'm getting another neck adjustment, and it is actually stiff. I probably should, but I'm not. Yeah, so I had to walk out of the house looking kind of scrubby, but you know, that's all for a good cause. So, I'm back with more details on how I'm proposing to her tomorrow. Her brother, Ade, been a champ helping throughout the process, along with a few other key people that are really, really giving me some needed support and assistance. Shout outs and sincere heartfelt thank yous to you, Ade, to you, Sonia, to my sisters, Liz and Kate. All of you have been instrumental in helping me pull this off, some for emotional support and some for details. And Yusuf, also out to you. Yusuf's helping me hide the ring in a pouch in my jacket and my shirt. That's secured. He's also got my big camera to take good photos from the ground, my small compact bag, and I have packed that along with an envelope that has a car key inside of it. And that envelope says for Ade Mola Olatunbosun. That is so I can leave that key at the desk at the building where we park and everything for skydiving tomorrow. And he'll be able to retrieve the key, grab the tripod and Lola's nicer looking clothes out of that car, and maybe even a wig or whatever is needed for her hair to be on point and how she wants it to the best of her ability. So when she hits the ground, we'll hold up a sheet for her to change behind because she'll see me all dressed up in my shirt and jacket, semi-formal, not real formal. She'll see me and she'll want to be looking, you know, looking great, which I think she does even in sweatpants and t-shirts, but you know, whatever. I'm going to hit the ground first, followed by two of my buddies and a friend of Lola's, and then Lola will be last, and I'm going to make sure that that's the way that it goes down, to the best of my ability, of course. If Lola emotionally has to jump first, well, we'll roll with it as it happens. If I pull it off and I'm able to be the one that goes first, great. I'm going to get down to the ground, I'm going to change, I'm going to mount my phone, or whatever device is doing the Zoom call for everybody, and kind of narrate the last few minutes of me not being affianced. Because I know she's going to say yes. We've talked about it many times. So it's time to go do it. Yeah, it's going to be great. Here we go.
Alex, turn around. Alex, turn around. Alex, turn around. Get over there. Okay, we're good. Put that on.
Hey, Lola.
Hi! Oh my god, oh my god!
Welcome back,
you got my mother yet?
Liz, where's Liz? Liz, get over here. Get over here. Liz, get over here.
Everybody lied to me.
Oh,
I love you.
Oh, my God.
Thank you so much for coming here.
Oh, my God, Liz.
Thank you. Oh, my God. This is perfect.
Thank you, everybody, for coming. Thank you.
I have a loud group.
That's what I have.
Let me see that ring.
That's a Zoom call. That's a Zoom call with a bunch of people watching. A lot of family, and I forget who all's on
there. Let's turn it around and say hi.
You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning, 'cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. Imperfections. Give your all to me. Give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning. Even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me. Of me, and you give me all of you. Oh.